Good evening. The nation's supermarkets are being warned to lift their game and lower prices or face billions of dollars in fines. An interim report wants to see a mandatory code of conduct imposed on the biggest players, particularly Coles and Woolworths, to prevent customers and suppliers being ripped off.
Tonight, an interim report into supermarkets promising lower prices or larger fines.
I see this as actually being supportive, not only of the suppliers, but ultimately of shoppers.
The report stating the existing food and grocery code of conduct is not effective, suggesting a compulsory code with penalties of up to $10 million or 10% of supermarkets' annual turnover, whichever is greatest.
The defining motivation behind this is a fair go for farmers and families. The current voluntary code is too easy to walk away from, and we want to change that.
Ruling out so-called divestiture powers, breaking up the major supermarkets and forcing them to sell land holdings.
The supermarkets own 74% of the market. They are the market. They have you over the barrel.
Unless the concentration of market power of Coles and Woolworths is adequately addressed, nothing will change.
While smaller parties want the supermarket split, the Liberal Party is being split by the supermarkets.
It's a good start, but we also think a targeted divestment power is also necessary.
There is always concern with divestiture powers, whether they will actually decrease prices.
We want our businesses to be profitable and successful, and we want them to hire people.
For producers, new minimum standards for supply agreements are recommended, plus protections for farmers who make complaints against supermarkets.
Having the ability to call out bad behaviour without commercial retribution is really important.
The ultimate test will be whether prices come down. The government keenly aware that groceries are a weekly or sometimes daily reminder of the cost of living battle across Australia.
The supermarkets say they are cooperating and the final report will go to the government in June. Charles Croucher, Nine News.
And political editor Charles Croucher joins me now. Charles, what's been the response from the supermarkets?
Evening, Georgie. Well, both Coles and Woolies helped write the grocery code. They both agree making it mandatory will help consumers. But tonight, they want the code expanded. In submissions to the Amazon Review, they argue retailers like Amazon, Bunnings and Chemist Warehouse all sell products found in supermarkets and therefore should fall under the code as well. This isn't currently in the review, but those involved say it could be considered. For now, through the sheer number of complaints and sheer number of reviews going on, Georgie, the focus will likely remain on the supermarkets.
Charles Croucher, thank you.